Hi my dearests, in our today's video we're going to be talking about this. So what is this? You have good injectors, but you have also black smoke out of your exhaust. You smell fuel out of your engine bay. So what can we do about that? Your issue may be this little thing. This, or better say it, this is a cold seal ring. And when this seal ring goes bad, then fuel starts flowing out of your plunger and it makes you various issues. So how do we replace this little thing? Let's see that right now. When replacing the seal ring, this is the picture you're gonna see. In order to replace the seal ring, you will have to remove the fuel distributor. In order to remove it, first thing, you will have to unclip the plug coming from the EHA. Then you will have to unscrew this line. This line goes here. This is the differential pressure line. This line goes here, so you will have to practically remove the fuel pressure regulator. Afterwards, you will have to remove the plug for the cold start valve, for the injectors, and then you can simply we have here, before you unclip the cold start valve, you will have to remove this fitting for it here. And why? This is why. You have three Torx screws here that you will also have to remove. These three hold the fuel distributor, as well as this line. From here, the fuel goes into the fuel distributor, into the lower chamber. As you are done, you simply take it like this. And that's it. Here you have one seal also, which I don't have. Of course, one more thing, you will have to prepare some kind of rag or something, because this one is very dry. There is no fuel inside. But you will have to prepare something to absorb the fuel. The second step, you don't have to remove the EHA at all. You flip this fuel distributor upside down. And now, an extremely important thing, crucial, however you say it, you will have to take something like this. It's called caliper, and you will have to measure the distance between the sleeve. This is called sleeve, and the nut, this nut, and that must be 0.6 mils. You will have to measure it and you must get like this, 0.6 mils. Again, measuring from here, the gap, from here to the nut. The next step would be to remove the sleeve. You can take something plastic, something in order not to damage this sleeve here. If you remember in my videos, I was taking a pencil for this purpose, so you can do that also. And now, as you have removed the sleeve, this is that seal ring. You will have to take this off. Nothing. You don't have to touch the plunger or nothing. Basically nothing here. You will have to touch nothing from these screws here. Nothing. This. You will have to order this one here if it's bad. As you do this, you just put everything in a reverse order. So here again, just like this. The mine should be mounted like this, and again like this. And as you're done, you take the caliper and you measure depth. And as you read again, 0.6 mils, like this, then you're good to go. Well, now it's everything about the reversal. Also look out for this O-ring here, not to lose it. And that's pretty much it. If you like this video, then you know what you have to do. And till the next one, happy Mercedes-ing. Bye.